back pain. I mean, I'm sure you guys read statistics about low back pain occurring in men. That is the number one cause, that is the number one ailment that men suffer from. So oftentimes when we get to the root of the cause, oftentimes assessing the men if they need to, then they're able to reproduce a child, which is amazing. It actually was personal for me because my sister tried everything, and family is always the most difficult patients. And so then what happened is she started getting adjusted. Now, thank you, Jesus, I have a nephew and a niece. It also decreases serotonin levels. It also decreases your immunity. As a matter of fact, the October is flu and cold month. So at this point in time, you should be focusing on increasing immunity, doing everything in your capacity to make sure that you're healthy. Now, it increases your blood pressure, it increases heart rate, it also increases muscle spasm, cholesterol, anxiety, and fear. Now, there's three types of categories of stress that I'd like to cover. The first is probably the most obvious, and that's body stresses. Second is soul stresses, and third is spiritual stresses. The first one is traumatic stresses. Now, trauma, what I'm talking is about acute injuries such as car accidents, sports injuries, slips and falls, the work injuries, and also the birth process. Now, the reason why I made sure the birth process was last, because in my opinion, after delivering over 400,000 adjustments, I know that the birth process is probably the most traumatic event that our bodies go through. Mm-hmm. Being 48, if I fall and I trip over the curb, I'll sit there and cry. Please, somebody, find Dr. Jacob or Dr. Solinger or Dr. Ryan to adjust me. And so then that's why I wanted to make sure I specifically pointed out the birthing process. Not just because I have a fellowship in pediatrics, but because I truly believe after 400,000 adjustments, the birthing process is probably the most traumatic event our bodies go through. I don't know anyone that didn't go through the birthing process or foregone the birthing process. So with that said, that is the most traumatic event. The second form of trauma or body stress is chemical stresses. Now, chemical stresses are, and now 50 years ago, we really never really focused on this, but now we focus on the pesticides on fruits and vegetables, also animal husbandry, such as hormones, antibiotics in our meats, poultry, and dairy. I mean, when was the last time you saw a sick cow? Thank you. They pump our food full of antibiotics. If you're not aware of it, they do. So this way, they can have a healthy product for sale. Next is recreational, but more especially pharmaceutical drugs. At this point in time, I mean, if you've been watching TV, something I rarely ever do, but if you watch TV, I really believe that we're desensitized to all the side effects of what the medication actually does to us. Because we've been seeing it for so long, it just becomes part of our culture. You can't allow that. Because, I mean, literally, it's our bodies that they're trying it on. It's your family. And then chemical stresses are toxic air and water, and also processed foods. And by the way, all of these other stresses, we have other workshops, and we will be, and I pray that you guys are in attendance, because we'll deliver the most current, most powerful information, but we'll also give you alternatives, so this way you can live a healthier life. Now, with that said, the third type of stress I'd like to talk about is movement deficiency syndrome. Now, movement deficiency syndrome, the first one is sitting, like you're doing right now, that's not good for our bodies, because our body's not designed to sit at a desk, and for surfing the web, computer games, and so forth. And Savita put this picture up here, right here. This one, she thought that was cute. Anyway, because I mean, really, that's the generation now. That's really our generation. As a matter of fact, Cornell University stated that children in elementary schools are at risk from sitting at improper workstations that have been designed with little or no regard for musculoskeletal development, and this has implications for health problems. Mm-hmm. Children's developing musculoskeletal structures are especially vulnerable to postural traumas, and sitting for more than short periods of time increases the risk of injuries. You couple that with backpacks, you now know why you suffer from back pain. As a matter of fact, in our office, we focus on posture because posture is the window to your spine and nervous system. Posture affects and moderates all human functions, both consciously and unconsciously, from breathing to hormone and to thinking. The fourth type of stress I'd like to talk to you about is subluxation. Now, according to Dr. James Chestnut, subluxation causes exercise deficiency syndrome. And he states, by preventing joints from moving properly, it creates movement deficiency resulting in bone and soft tissue degeneration and disafferentation. So subluxation or lack of movement increases the amount of deterioration and degeneration within your body. If you've ever known anyone that had a shoulder injury, the natural tendency is to do this. Mm-hmm. And then they don't move it. And anybody knows what that the end result of that is called? Frozen shoulder. And there's 7 muscles involved. And so with that said, when you come in like that, it takes time for your body to heal. And that's what he's talking about when he talks about exercise deficiency syndrome. Dr. Chestnut also says that subluxation complex represents deficiency in required brain stimulation and results in decreased brain function. Let me share that again. The subluxation complex represents deficiency in required brain stimulation and results in decreased brain function, as brain function is integral to homeostasis and health in cells, tissue, organs, and systems. This allows for an understanding of global psychological, physiological negative effects that the subluxation causes. So subluxation affects everything. So what's the answer? It's the adjustment, the chiropractic adjustment. The adjustment stimulates proprioceptive input into the cerebellar vermis, which is back here, that in turn acts on the amygdala, the hippocampus, and the hypothalamus. In what Dr. Jensen has termed the movement pleasure and movement learning pathways. In short, movement, which is always abundantly present during fight and flight and non-sedentary and non-subluxated human beings during the normal daily life, is the innate way we have to return to homeostasis. So the adjustment returns our body back to homeostasis, back to normality. By the way, I wanted to share all of that with you. I've been a martial artist my entire life. I've never been a forms guy. I've been one of those guys, okay, teach me the moves and then put me in a ring and let me fight, because then I can pick it up and I can respond the way I need to, because that's the way my mind works. However, today, when it comes to validation of how chiropractic can help you, we have all the research. If you were to ask me that 14 years ago, we didn't have the validation as abundantly as it is today. So with that said, the boring part done, let's start talking. Okay, good. So now, the second form of stress is soul stress. Now, soul stress is of the mind, the will, and also the emotions. Now, this is where I believe I excel and I can help you, is because oftentimes our thought process causes us to create that negative feeling within us. The statements, I should've, I could've, now only if I would've, now because I didn't, I have to, and because I shoulda, woulda, coulda, and now I have to. I am so. That's why, I mean, it's not uncommon for you to hear from me. No negative self-talk in my office. I'm not gonna allow that. No negative self-talk. You create your change in your life. You create your destiny. It results in this conversation, results in worry, it results in fear, it results in anxiety. As a matter of fact, Harvard Mind Body Institute, last technical documentation here, I like Harvard. Anybody like Harvard? Okay, good. Especially with the Mind-Body Institute. All right. Neurological research reveals that before we consciously color our world around us with our thinking and acquired beliefs, the subconscious brain mechanism mark our perceptions, forming opinions, and assigning value. before we even have a chance to mull over the presence of a new sight, or sound, regions of our subconscious brain reacts by assigning an initial but influential value to it. These automatic attitudes make us incapable of utter objectivity and neutrality in more profound ways than we've ever suspected. Think about little Johnny. If little Johnny just really was a bad child. Not saying that there's a Johnny and a bad child, but I'm just saying hypothetically. Johnny was really a bad child, and unfortunately you were the parent of little Johnny. If you received a call from the school, would you think good or bad? You colored it already. You colored it. That's what this research is talking about. It says that's just what we do. So what is the solution? The good news is that we can program our belief system to be congruent with our innate values. This makes our automatic values not neutral, but positive, optimistic, loving, forgiving, gracious, etc. I mean, really, at the end of the day, who really wants to be neutral? We must understand that we get to choose the pathways we consistently fire. We will always get efficient at what we repetitively stimulate. If you want to be depressed, then think depressing thoughts. If you want to be happy, guess what thoughts you have to think? Happy thoughts. I mean, really, just by a show of hands, okay? Who wants to be happy? Thank you. Do you know that there's an actual movie out there on how to be happy? Because at the end of the day, what are we looking for? Are we looking for success? Because if you're really looking for success, I'm sure if I were to inquire with everyone here, everyone's definition of success would be different. But now, what if you're just looking to be happy? To make it absolutely clear, how we consistently talk to ourselves, the content of our internal dialogue, determine which pathways we fire, which genes we stimulate, and which biochemistry and physiology we express. You are your thoughts and you are your actions. The key to success, to reducing stress, is personal change. And that's what I'm hoping that you just received, and that's what I'm hoping that you start practicing. Creating health and happiness is about understanding your internal dialogue is a choice, and it represents your interpretation of your environment. We really do create our own reality. The fourth kind of stress is spiritual stress. The big questions. I mean, really, for me, these are why I live. No questions like, who made